IHGN Studios. It's Braves Beat.
Hello, Braves, and welcome to our 13th episode of Braves Beat. I'm Sam Huell.
And I'm Sydney Frost.
So, Sydney, do you have a wild committee for the Windy City?
Of course, Sam. I can't wait to go to Chicago with my best friends, Sarka, Vinya, and Yamini.
Well, there's a lot of news to cover, so let's get on with it.
Last Thursday evening, our school hosted the class of 2027 to tour the high school and to get to know all the ins and outs of becoming a freshman at Indian Hill. It was so nice to meet all the potential Indian Hill High School students. Thank you to all NHS members for helping host this memorable tradition.
For the third year in a row, the Indian Hill School District congratulates students in the Indian Hill Robotics Club for earning a $2,200 robotics grant from PNG. My co-host had the chance to interview Mrs. Smith. Let's take a look.
Hey Braves, I'm here with Mrs. Smith, the engineering teacher here at Indian Hill. So Mrs. Smith, since this is the third year you guys are receiving this grant, what do you think makes Indian Hill Robotics Club stand out?
I think it's our fabulous team members. We have a very large robotics team and they are very active. We have a lot of visibility. If you've seen the field that sits in the neighborhood, we have a lot of kids that are here on Wednesdays and Thursdays practicing robotics and driving the bots, and we've got a large middle school team and a large high school team. I think it's that energy and enthusiasm of our students that make the team stand out.
What will the program put the grant money towards?
Most of the money will go towards the middle school. We have a very large sixth grade group this year, bigger than we've ever had before. So we had to add a fourth team to the middle school teams. So that's what most of the money will go towards, is the growing that middle school program.
What are some upcoming goals this year for the Indian Hill Robotics Club?
Win our competitions. We've got a competition coming up at Loveland on December 10th, and then we'll be at Harrison and Milford in February. So our goals are to do well in the competitions. We've got our state competition coming up and then followed by Worlds. So we're hoping to do well at our competitions, make it to state, and make it to Worlds.
Well, good luck. One final question for you. Is there anything else you'd like to add?
Go Braves.
Well, thank you for interviewing with me today.
Awesome, thank you.
Yep, back to you at the news desk.
Be the Difference Day enforces the idea that we need to understand other people through the use of large group games and small group conversations. What a neat event. Ashwini and Izzy have yet another marvelous sports report for us, so let's kick it on over.
Hey Braves, it's me, Ashwini.
And me, Izzy.
Wait a minute, that's not right.
Saturday, the girls' cheer team was named CHL champions again. We're so proud. Sunday was also Winter Sports Media Day.
A few of our reporters had a chance to be there and get clips of the teams in their press conferences. Here's the cheer team's conference.
So, Caroline, how does the team feel about winning CHL back-to-back?
It was a really exciting experience, and we're all really proud of like what we've become as a team.
And then what are you guys most excited for the rest of the season?
We're excited to be able to compete at state and then nationals in Florida later this year.
And then what expectations do you have for your team?
I would say consistency and passion throughout the rest of the season and just continuing to grow as a team.
Next are the boys and girls basketball teams.
All right, Lexi, what is your team's best qualities?
We're all really hardworking and supportive of one another, and we're just the best.
So Nathan, what are your ambitions for this season?
I want to compete every night, and I want to hustle and win every game.
Wrestling's up next.
My expectations for my coaches are just to be in there every day, making us work hard and getting us better.
Then bowling.
Sky, how does it feel to represent your school in a new sport?
I'm going to say it's rewarding because it's like a sport I've been passionate about for all these years, and then it's finally being represented in my school that I've been going at for almost the same time, so it feels pretty good.
Lastly, here is diving.
Marisol, what are some of your team's best qualities?
I would say we're pretty close-knit. We've been together for a while now, so we're pretty good together, and we kind of treat each other like sisters. Like, we fight like sisters, and we compliment each other like sisters. So, yeah, I think we'll be pretty good this season.
We are so excited for the winter sports season to start and to see how well the teams do this year.
That's all the sports news for this week. Back to Sydney and Sam at the news desk.
Keep up the great work, brave athletes.
Fellowship of Christian Athletes is sponsoring a winter gear collection drive. Wyatt Higgins had a chance to interview Zachary Jones.
Hey Braves Beat, I'm here with one of the leaders of FCA, Zachary Jones, and he is going to talk about the coat drive going on in FCA.
Yeah, so we're doing a coach drive until the 29th of November. So each grade is competing individually. You can bring in coats, jackets, sweatshirts, gloves, just anything you think you could use for the winter. And the class that donates the most will win a Chick-fil-A gift card for each student.
Thank you, Zach.
This past Friday was the annual global dinner in the high school cafeteria. All students were able to experience something new and different. Reese Tuttle has this report.
Okay, I'm here with
Mateo,
Kiara,
Francesca.
And how do you guys say welcome in your language?
Bem-vindos.
Benvenuti.
Hi, Braves Beat. We are at the Global Dinner, and we have Baron, which is one of the main organizers of this event. So tell us a little bit about what's going on here.
We are with Global Parents Group, and this is our annual dinner. As you see, we have a lot of people here tonight. Over 200 people signed up. It's a potluck dinner, so everybody brings a dish, and it's typically their cuisine. So we have this international feast going on here. So this is to bring our families together, to bring cultural awareness to the district, to our students. So we are very excited.
Yes, and I think we're also happy. It's a great turnout, and I want to thank you personally from Indian Hill for putting this event back together. Back to you at the desk.
What an amazing event to bring cultures together. Several members of our Braves Beat team got together to compete in a cooking contest, aka Hex Kitchen.
Do you have like a...
Hello, we're making teriyaki chicken.
Now we're adding the pasta to the boiling water to make our chicken pasta.
A strainer?
Yes.
Yeah.
Now smell it.
Oh, that's hot.
Now smell it.
Camera eats first.
This is Dylan and Wyatt's dish. It looked a bit scrappy in the beginning, but they pulled a product worth my palate together. I will be tasting it. Come in here. Hello, Chef. Hello, boys. Hello, Chef. I don't know how you managed to make food this great.
Wow.
I'm really impressed.
Thank you, Chef. It means
good
a lot.
Good work. I really like the complexity of this meal. Cheese. Cheese and this. Chicken. Good. And chicken. Get in here. Ladies, I have a question for you. Do you enjoy making food this poor? Look at this. Well, I suppose one of them had to go. Girls, I never want to see you in my kitchen ever again. It's really too bad. I like this dish, but I really hated the beanie. This is our tonight's winner. I would like to thank you, Dylan and Wyatt.
That looks yummy.
Tickets for Cabaret went live on Sunday. Make sure you grab some tickets so that you don't miss this one night only experience.
So, Sydney, do you know why the turkey was taken into custody?
Why, Sam?
Because he was suspected of aggravated assault.
What?
I don't know. The police suspected he had stuffing in his system and a history of poor impulse control.
Okay. Well, that's all we have this week, folks. Be sure to follow us on Twitter, subscribe to us on YouTube, and email us with any school updates.
And remember to stay tuned at the end of this episode for our Thanksgiving skit by our fifth period team.
And remember, stay classy, Indian Hill.